How's it going, Dazzlers? Welcome back to Daz Games, another Daz Watches. You guys have been asking me for like weeks on end now to basically react to some Dr. Phil requests. So I was like, okay, who do you want me to watch? And they were like, this girl. Not sure what her name is, but you guys have been linking me this video and you want me to react to her. And there's a bunch of other side videos here of her. So I guess we can watch multiple ones. But she's known in the title as Teen High School Dropout, who has a bright future. So she dropped out of high school. We don't know why. Let's delve into this, shall we?
Tell me about your bright future. Describe it for me and how it's going to unfold.
I have a bright future if she's dropped out of high school. I sense sarcasm, Dr. Phil.
I'm going to school so I can get my GED, and it counts just as much as a high school diploma. And
well, how are you going to get that if you dropped out? You kind of need to keep going. That's the point. What the fuck is my hair doing? What's that?
Then
I thought you said high school was stupid.
It is, but you do have to get some sort of education or else you're nothing. You won't ever get a job. You can't do anything.
High school is stupid. It's so stupid, but you kind of need it because otherwise you can't get a job. You're nothing. Maths is also important. Like, they ain't gonna hire me if I can't count shit. Like, you know, high school is stupid. I've never seen so much contradiction in such a short space of time in my life. High school is stupid, but you kind of need it. It kind of helps you out in your whole life. So it's not really that stupid then, is it?
And I'm planning on going to college for cosmetology and crime scene investigation.
She's dropping out of high school and she's gonna go into crime scene investigation? Can you imagine? Oh my god, I have to make a sketch on this girl. Can you imagine if this girl, without any sort of education at all, just got a job in crime scene investigation?
Jonathan, what do we got? We got one dead body, multiple gun wounds. Male, possibly in his late 40s.
Oh my god, he looks hideous. Did he die taking a selfie?
What? No, that's Alberto. That's our crime scene camera guy. Hello? He's not the dead body.
I see. But wait.
Whoa, wait, what are you doing?
Oh, I don't know, Johnson. Stopping criminal scum?
I'm not a criminal!
Then you want to tell me what you're doing at an active crime scene?
Because I'm a crime scene investigator.
Your story checks out. Lucky for you, I'm not on my period.
Oh, wait, you can't take that. It's a crime scene prop. It's probably got evidence on it.
Yeah, I can.
Why?
Because fuck you, that's why. Okay, now if you excuse me, I'm going outside to my car and I'm having a cigarette.
That's the broom closet. Holy shit.
Yep, that's I think pretty accurate.
News for
but
us.
We don't get to know that because we're not in her bubble.
Why is that funny? Like, that's a professional thing to do.
What does that mean they're not?
If you can't count to five, then you can't count the bullet holes in the victim's ass, love, okay? You need to go to school. What? Oh my god.
Not in your bubble.
They're not a part of my life. They're not going to be a part of my future. My dad is. That one over there is not.
Why is that?
Because she's a psychopath, and I honestly wish she would be locked away. Throw away the key, never come back ever again.
Wow, someone's grounded. Thing is, if you look at her, she just, you know, she could be just a lovely, normal girl. I wonder what made her so angry. I sense something that's bad in the past. She's very angry and defensive, maybe. I don't know. Let's watch more.
What is a psychopath? Wow.
She's ruined my life for the
past
6 years.
You define psychopath.
Okay,
you said
psychopath is, she's constantly
I don't mean her, just what's, you said she's...
doesn't know Dr. Phil, she dropped out of high school. She can't tell you what a psychopath is. She don't know her ABCs.
A psychopath. Okay, define psychopath for me.
Is you mentally cannot think straight, you mentally do not think your age, and you have, like, you just don't think right. You don't think like a normal human would. You don't have a thought process.
So you're a psychopath. Oh man, please. Someone help this girl, please. Oh my god. I don't really watch talk shows much because, you know, I just can't stand the fact that people pay tickets to watch people's life fall apart. You know, it's like Jerry Springer or Jeremy Kyle, and you wanted to just sit in there going boo, and it's like these are real people. Well, some of them are real, a lot of them are fake. But like these are real stories. These are real people's lives falling apart. This kid here, people might make fun of her and think, oh man, what a bitch. There's something that's made her like this. You know what I mean?
Interesting.
What was that? The fuck was that? Did someone just tickle the back of her brain? What was that?
Interesting.
That's the face I make. I can't make that joke.
Well, that's not what psychopath means at all.
Okay, but... then define it. Wow. Since I know that's what you love to do is to
But I think what you're saying is you two don't connect. You don't have a relationship with her. She doesn't understand you.
I don't want to have a relationship. I want nothing to do with her.
You don't, but last night you wanted me to come over and rub on your legs and do things.
Yeah, because...
You know. Why? Why is no one talking about that? I'm sorry. I mean, I know they're mother and daughter. I'm not saying there's anything funny going on. I'm just saying, like, that's a weird thing to text your mum. I don't know. Mum, please help me.
What is it, sweetie?
I don't know. I just really need you to come over and rub my legs right now. No, fuck off.
I want you to do things for me.
Oh, you see that girl in the audience? She's like, oh, hell no. Oh, hell no. Only girls can do that. I've never really seen a guy go... It's just a female thing.
So you say you've skipped every day when repeating the ninth grade.
Oh yeah, I skip school all the time. School is irrelevant for me. Besides, like, as soon as I get my GED.
Not irrelevant then, is it? Because you need something out of it. It's contradicting. You can't say that school is stupid and then skip it all and everything. And then get, you know, no one's gonna hire you if you don't go to school. They're not gonna ask you to confirm a dead body in a crime scene if you don't even know what a crime scene is.
Start my life because I'm already an adult. I've been an adult since I was little.
You've been an adult since you were little. How's that work? What? I'm not even sure that fucking makes sense.
No! You don't do anything. What Nanny and Papa do stuff for me. They have bought me everything. You didn't even buy me a car.
Oh shit. Damn. The parents are to blame here, clearly. Okay? They didn't buy her a car. Oh! It's so much abuse in the world, you know?
Entitled to have this car anyways, and because you-
Oh my god, I'll take the bus, I'll walk, I don't care, I don't need a car!
Why are you angry then? You're just moaning at them because they didn't buy you a car, and then you're like, I don't need one. They should rename her Miss Contradiction, because she says one thing, and does another. Like, I don't know.
I have no respect for my mom. I call my mom by her name, Kimber, because I don't see her as a mom. My dad is everything, but I honestly-
Your dad's got eyebrow game. I'll give him that. Did you see that shit?
My dad is everything, but-
He's like, hit me up, Dr. Phil. I don't know. Maybe she blames the mum for, like, the separation. I don't know. I'm trying to guess what's wrong here in this situation. She seems very kind of deluded in a way.
Since I'm not in high school right now, I normally go to the skate park. This is me at the skate park.
Is that her vlogging? Really? You gotta have some sort of energy when you're vlogging nowadays. You can't just be chill. No, you have to be like you're on ecstasy. You know, you can't just be like, hey guys, I'm at the skate park. What's up? You need to be like, what's up, dudes? What the fuck? You need to be off your face on something, all right? If you're going to be a vlogger, you need to scream, shout, ask your following to just completely annihilate and destruct the like button. All right, she's missing out on so many vlogging techniques.
Smoking weed or smoking cigarettes. I was 14.
Where does she get the money for the weed? Someone's given her money. Don't give her any money. Like, come on.
When I started smoking marijuana, my parents found out and they said, as long as I don't hurt anyone or myself by it, they don't care. I smoke.
Go then. That's it, isn't it? They don't care. I mean, there's a complete lack of, you can't just slap an iPad in your kid's hand and say, there, that keeps them quiet. Now I can go drink my wine downstairs with my new husband. Like, you gotta pay attention. You know, you gotta constantly be a parent. This is a full-time job, all right? Once you're 18, it doesn't stop. You just keep going as a parent forever till you're dead. That's it. That's when your job ends, okay? Even then, as a ghost, you gotta come back into their room and spook the shit out of them. You gotta be like, ooh, Kevin! Pick the shit up.
Every day. If my parents claim they don't know that I smoke weed, that's a total lie. If I'm not at the skate park, then I'm normally at home watching YouTube videos.
Okay. On the iPad, watching YouTube. Probably don't know what she watches, who she idolizes. Don't pay attention. God damn it.
Yes. My dream is definitely to become a YouTube star.
My dream is to find out why the fuck your scarves are moving in the background.
My dream is definitely to become a YouTube star.
Why is it moving in the background like that? What's going on? Ghosts? I think so!
I do have 3 YouTube channels. Some of my older videos are me doing makeup tutorial.
Not makeup tutorials, that's you poking yourself in the fucking eye. I don't think Zoella got to where she was by going, alright guys, so today I'm gonna blinded!
So that's what it looks like.
I also have some videos up on my YouTube channel called Dare Mondays.
Dare Mondays!
In one episode, I was dared to eat baby powder.
There's a serious, serious lack of care that goes into, I just called all of this. Stop texting me. I just called all of this a minute ago. Like, I really think that the internet is such a powerful tool. Like, there are so many kids that get lost, so lost in the internet and idols and ideas and thoughts, and there's so much information in front of them now that they flush out the information in their own heads. So some kids can't even find a fucking identity, let alone parents that can talk to them. I think that kids learn so much or take in so much from the internet and their iPods and their computers that they stop taking in things that they should be. When I was a kid, if my friend came up to me and said, Daz, eat a Tide Pod or eat some baby powder, I'd say, no, you fucking idiot. No, ugh. Why would I do that? Nowadays, their idols and everything are, you know, doing crazy shit and setting themselves on fire and doing terrorist pranks, and there's so much shit that goes on that it's constantly going in and out of their heads. And like, a lot of these kids, I don't know, they ain't even in the right minds. I don't know. The
most views I've gotten on my YouTube channel was 85.
Rah!
I feel like my parents are just blowing everything out of proportion. They just need to stop worrying. I feel like I have a bright future ahead of me. I just think that Kimber needs to step out of my life.
People don't realize about talk shows and stuff is these kind of shots. Let me find it. Like, where she's up against the tree, staring into the distance here.
Future ahead of me, I just...
She's been told to do that. Like, she's been directed to do that. To be lost in thought. That this is the problem with talk shows, even ones such as Dr. Phil. Like, all drama is good for them. And this kid, if this is all real, doesn't need to be treated like a movie star and told to do all that. And even her mother, like, there's a shot with her mum that I noticed. All right, ma'am, if you could just look down at the floor like you've lost all hope, and we'll circle around to get the Michael Bay shot. It's this type of shit, as a filmmaker, that I notice, and these tactics. Same sort of thing, where, like, Logan Paul is, like, playing piano over an apology. Like, it's all dramatic effect. It's all to pull on your heartstrings, and it's all false. They're basically acting to dramatize the situation, which is already bad enough. Like, all you gotta do is sit that kid down, tell a story, and that's it. You don't need dramatic music, camera shots, acting. That's why I don't like talk shows. They either fake everything, which shows that kids can be bad and get famous, or they over-dramatize the situation. It's already very dramatic, and people just need help. You know what I mean? I don't like talk shows. I never have. You know, I could go around in circles, but the basic principle is that there's a lot going on here, and at such a young age, when you don't really understand mental health, and you don't really understand anything other than the fact that your parents are acting crazy or embarrassing, and even though they can't control it, you know, I feel like she kind of hates her mum for being born as her daughter because she's crazy. But when she grows up and she really matures and hopefully stays sane and gets her ass back into school, hopefully she'll might grow up to realize it wasn't my mum's fault. It's just, you know, but it was hard on me. And I imagine it's so hard on her as well and the whole family. I don't know really who they are. I just got asked to watch this by you guys. But it is a point to point out that most people behave the way they do, usually not because they're just being an asshole, but it's because there's something there that you don't understand. When you see a massively obese person, a lot of people might go, oh my God, why would you keep eating? You have no idea why that person got to that state. You can't judge them based on appearances. Don't judge a book by its cover is really the story here. Guys, thank you so much for requesting me this video. I never really watched Dr. Phil before. Now I can say I have. Like, love, crest my channel, and I will see you in the next video. Stay dazzling.